Students, how are you? I hope that you are fine. Now let us start our today lesson. Our today lesson is a new topic, which is about further on trigonometric. So our today lesson will be further on trigonometry. That means you know something about this topic. Our today lesson, you know something about it because it says what? Further. We are adding something what you have learned in your lower grades. What you have learned in grade 8, what you have learned in grade 7, we are going to add what? Some pointers. But before we go to there, what do you remember about trigonometry? Can you define what trigonometry is? Do you remember the most important trigonometric ratios that you have learned in your grade 8? Okay. Let us see together. If you forget or if you remember both of them, again we will see more about trigonometry. Now let us see together. An angle is the union of two rays with a common end point. Angle is formed when two rays has a common point. At that time we can say there is what? An angle. And a figure form, it is this. Now this ray OA and ray OB makes an angle, OO makes an angle. O is the vertex while the two rays are the sides of the angle. From this, the trigonometry is always dependent on angles. In general, we associate each angle with a real number called measure of the angle. The two measures that are most frequently used are degree and radian. Everything has a unit. If we measure an angle, we will express it a number with some units. If we measure distance or length, we will write a number, pure number, with a unit. Just like that, angles have a number, pure number, plus a unit. Most of the units that the world uses are what we call degree and radian. Ardayay sidaa fasaladiina hore aad ku soo barateenba xagal waxay leedahay hal beeg. Tusaale ahaan, haddii aan ka sheekeyneyno lacagteena, lacagta dalkeena oo laba bir ayaa la oranayaa. Laba waa tiradii, birtuna waxay sheegaysaa intii ay ahayd. Halbeegeedii ba sheegaysaa laba bir. Just like that, haddaad iga cabiray sidoo kale fogaanta ama dhararka oo dhexeeya laba barood, waxaad oran kartaa waa 3 kilomitir ama waa 3 mitir badan ama waa 100 mitir badan. Boqolku waa tiro, mitirkuna waa halbeegii tilmaamay. Just like that, sidaas oo kale haddaba xagluhuna waxay leeyihiin halbeeg, tiro iyo halbeeg. Halbeegyada inta badan ee la isticmaalo, ee loo isticmaalo xaglaha waxaa ka mid ah degree iyo radian. Inkastoo ay jiraan minute iyo second, ay jiraan iyaguna daqiiqad iyo ilbiriqsana lagu cabiri karo xagasha marka aad u sii yartahay. Okay, now let us see radian measure of an angle. Halbeegeenagana halbeegii lagu cabirayay xaglaha. Halbeegii xaglaha ee ahaa radian, degree. You are familiar with the degree measure, isn't it? So now this is the radian measure. A radian measure denoted by rad is defined as the measure of the central angle subtended by an arc of a circle equal in length to the radius of the circle. If we see this in figure, it is in this form. Halki rad mhulem yahay, that means ega radka hal radka centerka ama xudunta goobada xagasha ka samaysantay ayaa ah hal rad. Oo maxay la mid tahay? Waxay la mid tahay qaansada ka soo horjeeda oo la mid ah dhararka gacanka goobada. That means wareegii goobada oo ah 360 degree iyo 2 by R oo lagu heli 2 by R lagu heli jiray ayaa isku mid ah halkan. That means one revolution is equal to 360 degree, which is equal to 2 by radians. Halkan waxaanu ka heli karnaa haddaan dhinac kastaba laba qaybano in 180 degree uu la mid yahay by. So here we can say from this 180 degree is equal to by radian, and from this we have 1 radian is equal to 180 degree over by, which is approximately 57.3 degree. And 1 degree is equal to by over 180 radian, which is approximately 0.0175 rad. Hadda halkan waxaanu ka fahmaynaa ama aynu ka qaadan karnaa inaynu isku bedeli karno hal beegyada radian iyo degree. Sida aad ku soo baratay fasalladaadii hore ee isugu bedeli jirtay maadada physics-ka oo kale, sida isugu bedeli jirteen mitirka, kilometer, centimeter, sida loogu bedelayo oo kale, waynu isugu bedeli karnaa labadan halbeeg ee xaglaha ee kala ah degree-ga waynu bedeli karnaa radian. Radian-kana waxaynu bedeli karnaa degree, waynu bedeli karnaa. Okay, therefore we have the following conversion rules for degrees and radians. Haddaba si aynu isugu bedelno waxaanu isticmaalaynaa labadan sharci ayaan isticmaalaynaa. To convert radians to degrees, multiply by 180 degrees over by. Oo fiirsada ardaye, haddii aad rabtid inaad radiankii aad u bedesho degree, maxaad ku dhufanaysaa wixii lagu siiyey lagu yidhi bedel 180 degree loo hoos dhigay by? Goor 180 degree loo hoos dhigay by aad ku dhufanaysaa waxa lagu siiyo? Waa markaad rabtid inaad radiankay u bedesho degree. To convert the radians to degrees, multiply by what? 180 degrees over by. This is one rule. Again, the other rule is what? To convert degrees to radians, multiply by over 180 degrees. Kana waxaad isticmaalaysaa marka aad leedahay inaad marka aad rabtid inaad u bedeshid degreegii radian. Waxaa lagu siin degree, degreegaasaa lagu odhan bedel. Haddii aad rabtid inaad bedeshid waxaad ku dhufanay by over 180 degrees. Example, convert the following to degrees. Kuwan maxaad u bedeli doontaa hadduu ilaahay yidhaahdo degrees? Degree baad u bedeleysaa. Maxay noqonayaan? Baad filaysaa iyagu in terms of radians will be given us. Okay, by over 3 and 2 by over 5. By over 3 we want to change into what? Into degree. 2 by over 5, we want to change it into degree again. Halkan waxaan ka fahmaynaa haddii uu cabirka lagu qorin oo lagu sheegin inuu radian yahay uu qaado. By over 3 waxaa la socdaa rad, radianka. 2 by over 5 radian baa kula socda. Haddaba kuwa waxaan rabnaa inaan u bedelno degree, maxaan samaynaa? We should have to apply the rule. To convert the radians to degree, multiply 180 over by. So let us see the solution. Solution. To convert the radian to degree, multiply by 180 degrees over by. Therefore, A, by over 3 is equal to by over 3 times 180 degrees over by. By you can cancel. When we 3 divide for 1, it is 3. When we divide 3 for 180, it is 60 degrees. Therefore, what we can say here is what? By over 3 marka loo bedelo degree, waa 60 degrees. This is. Can you answer B? Can you change B? 2 by over 5, can you change it to degree? Okay, let us see again. B 2 by over 5 is equal to 2 by over 5 times 180 degrees over by. Now we can cancel the like terms, the corresponding numbers and the values. by you can cancel. By 5 you can divide for 180 degree. If we divide 5 for 180, it's 36. 36 times 2 is 72 degree. That is. So here we can see what? That 2 by over 5 is equal to 72 degree. 2 by over 5 radians is 72 degree. How it was? Okay, I hope it is interesting and simple still. Let us see another example. This example says convert each of the following to radians. A, 30 degree, B, 150 degree, C, 15 degree. We want to convert this to where? To radian. Do you remember what to do when we wanted to convert radian to degree? Okay, easy. Now let us see. Solution. To convert degrees to radians, multiply what you are given by over 180. Okay, so A, 30 degree is equal to 30 degree times by over 180 degree, which is equal to by over 6. Degree will cancel the degree, 0 by 0, 3 by 3, so it will become by over 6 rad. B, 150 degree is equal to 150 degree times by over 180 degree, and this will give us 5 pi over 6. Because when you simplify, you will get 5 pi over 6. That is, what about 15 degree? The same methodology, the same way. We will say 15 degree times 15 over pi over 180 degree, and this will become pi over 12 rad. Sometimes the rad can be obtained or omitted, okay? Now let us see trigonometrical ratios to solve right-angled triangles. To solve right-angled triangles, we use trigonometric ratios. Now let us see what we mean about trigonometric ratio. Okay. Trigonometric ratio is the ratio that describes the relationship between a side and angle of a triangle. The relationship between side and angle, what describes is called trigonometric ratio. My dear students, look well, try to understand this point. Trigonometric ratio is ratio that describes the relationship between a side and an angle of a triangle. Look this figure. Do you remember right angle triangle? The right angle triangle, its side is named by hypotenuse, opposite, adjacent. So the trigonometric ratios are the ratios of these sides. For example, sine is equal to opposite over hypotenuse. The ratio of opposite over hypotenuse is called sine. Again, cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse. This ratio is called cosine. And opposite over adjacent is called tangent. So these are the trigonometric ratios. So this describes the relationship between what? Angle and side. So when we want an opposite, opposite is known by always the given angle. Opposite ku hadhay chair wuxuu ku xidhan yahay xagasha lagu siiyo. Xagasha lagu siiyo dhinaca ka soo horjeeda ayaa la yidhaahdaa hadhay chair opposite. Because the word opposite tells you, ereygan opposite lagu leeyahayba wuxuu kuu sheegayaa inuu yahay ka soo horjeeda. Kolka xagasha lagu calaamaday hadii angle A la yidhaahdo, opposite-keedu waa small a, ka soo horjeeda xarafka yar ee A. Sidoo kale, hypotenuse-ku waa dhinaca ugu dheer. Shaki ma leh isagu, labada kale inaad isku qaldid laga yaabaa, balse hypotenuse-ku labada dhinac buu ka duwan yahay. Waa dhinaca ugu dheer ama ka soo horjeeda xagasha 90 degree. Eega C, xagasha C ee sawirka waa 90 degree. The side opposite to that is C, hypotenuse. Adjacent, kolba xagasha lagu siiyo ayuu la deris yahay. Deris weyn. Hypotenuse iyo adjacent way isku labadaas way isla socdaan. Xagasha A yaa deris la? Dhinac waa hypotenuse, dhinacna waa maxay? Waa adjacent bay ka dhigan tahay. So this is. So the ratios of opposite over hypotenuse is sine. The ratio adjacent over hypotenuse is cosine. The ratio opposite over adjacent is tangent. Example, in the right angle triangle below, find the values of sine, cosine, and the tangent of the acute angles. Do you know what acute angles are? Acute angles are what? The angles between 0 to 90 degree. Wa hagal fiqan area. Hagal fiqan way. Hagasha fiqan at the entity. Taota haise ever, Elias sagasha. Let us see the figure. This is the figure. Wa hana lagaraba. Inayna soo saarno. The sine of the acute angles. The cosine of the acute angles. Tangent of the acute angles. In what way can we find? How many acute angles do we have in this triangle? Emisa. Acute angle ba kugu jira meeshan. Sadde hagal kan ABC. There are two. Hagasha A iyo hagasha B ba. Waa hagla ka yar 90 degree. Haga hagasha C ka tahay hagal 90 degree. Now we will say solution. Sine of A is equal to oversight over hypotenuse. Oversight ku waayo. A marka lagu yidhaahdo dhinaca ka soo horjeeda hagasha A waayo. Waa 3 ba ka soo horjeeda. Dhinaca kale maxaynu bixinaynaa deriska laan. Adjacent waa 4. Hypotenuse kuna waa shanta ka ugu buuxin weeye. So sine is 3 over 5, cos A is 4 over 5, and tan A is 3 over 4. Hadda maxaynu helay? Now we get or we found the answer of one acute angle. What about the other acute angle? Let us say sine B, it is about 4 over 5, 3 over 5, as well as 4 over 3. Okay, the angle is 30 degree, 45 degree, and 60 degree are called special angles because they have this exact trigonometric ratios. This is the exact trigonometric ratios. Haglaha, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree, mahala wera, special angles balidada. Haglaha garka ah. Why? Sawta logu magadara, haglaha garka logu bihiwa mahi, wahai leyin, qimayal, go'an bay leeyahay la garan karo isla markaaba sine of 30 degree waa 1 over 2 cos of 30 degree waa radical 3 over 2 tan of 30 degree waa radical 3 over 3 and so on kolka kuwan waa inaad dusha ka qabataan you should have to always remember don't forget this because you will observe in different in your different core in different courses in physics you may use also in other subjects you may use this angles. Now let us see example. A ladder 6 meter long leans against a wall and makes an angle of 60 degree with the ground. Find the height of the wall. How far from the wall is the foot of the ladder? This is the ladder. Look, the ladder is 6 meters. It makes an angle of 60 degree with the ground. So we are asked to find the height of the wall as well as the distance from the foot of the wall to the wall. Now let us see together how we can solve. Solution, measure of angle A is 60 degree and BC stands for what? BC is the height of the wall and AC is the distance between the foot of the ladder and the wall. Now we can say sine of 60 degree is equal to oversight of our hypotenuse. Our oversight is BC and the ladder length is the hypotenuse. So we can say radical 3 of our 2 is equal to BC over 6. The radical 3 is from what? Sine of 60 degree. Radical 3 is okay, sine of 60 degree. Now we can find easily BC and say BC is equal to 3 radical 3 meter. That is height of the wall. Let us see the other. To find AC, use cos A. Cos of 60 degree is equal to adjacent of hypotenuse. The adjacent of this is AC over 6. But cos of 60 degree was what? 1 over 2. So multiply 6 by 1 over 2, we will get AC is equal to 3 meters. The distance from the foot of the ladder to the wall is 3 meters. Activity. This is your turn. Now try to do in your best. This activity says, what is the definition of trigonometric ratio? Do you remember? What are the names of the three trigonometric ratios? I hope so simple. Today, our activity is not calculation. It is about what we have described. Now, try to answer this too. You have 3 minutes. Write correctly. Okay, welcome back. Your time is over. Now let us see together the way you have answered these two. What is trigonometric ratio? Do you remember what was the trigonometric ratio? What you said is what? If you say a ratio that describes the relationship between side and the angle of a triangle, you get the correct answers. The names of the trigonometric ratios, almost they were three, isn't it? That three was what? Sine, cosine, tan, isn't it? Now let us, so this is trigonometric ratio, are ratios that describe the relationship between side and angle of triangle. Again, the three trigonometric ratios names are sine, cosine, and tangent. How many of you get this answer is? Okay, very good. That is all our today lesson. Till we meet our next lesson, you know what is expected from you. Do what is good for you. Read more, practice more, and try to prepare yourself for the next lesson. That is all. Goodbye.